Imagine we have a force F and a specified axis AA. The unit vector of axis AA is UA, which specifies the direction of this axis. To determine the moment caused by force F about this particular axis, we can draw an arbitrary position vector R. As long as it starts from an arbitrary point O on the axis, and ends anywhere on the line of action of force F. We can determine the moment caused by the force about point O, MO, using the vector equation MO equals to R cross F. However, the direction of this moment is not necessarily along the AA axis as we want it. In fact, we can determine the direction of this moment that it must be perpendicular to the plane formed by both vector F and vector R. But since moment is a vector, just like any other vector, we can resolve it into components according to the parallelogram law. Therefore, we can resolve it into one component MAA that is along the AA axis and another component that is perpendicular to the AA axis. As you can probably tell, the MAA component is simply the projection of MO along the AA axis. If we know the angle theta between vector MO and the AA axis, we can determine MAA to be MO times cosine theta. Notice that this is very similar to finding the projection of a force along a specified axis. And just like finding projection of a force, we can also use dot product. MAA equals to the dot product of unit vector UA and the moment vector MO. Or more directly, MAA can be determined by the dot product of UA and the cross product of vectors R and F, and therefore can be calculated using a matrix. Once again, UA is the unit vector along the AA axis about which you want to find the moment caused by the force vector F. And R is an arbitrary vector as long as it starts somewhere on the AA axis and ends somewhere on the force. Also, we know that dot product is a scalar. Therefore, if you want to find the moment along AA axis as a vector, you need to attach the unit vector UA to it. Let's look at this example. We know how the force F is directed from point A to point B. We also know its magnitude. We need to determine the moment caused by this force about an specified axis CD. Again, from an earlier example, I already expressed the force in Cartesian vector form. Now we need to find a position vector that starts anywhere on the CD axis and ends anywhere on the line of action of this force. So we have even more options. All of these, and all of these, and many, many more. Again, we want to pick a position vector that's easy to work with. So from inspection, I would choose the position vector RCB again. Now, we need to specify the direction of the axis CD. In other words, we need to find the unit vector UCD from the position vector RCD. And now we are ready to calculate the moment caused by this force F about this specified axis CD. We use this formula, filling the information in the matrix. The first, second, and third rows are the three components of the unit vector, position vector, and force vector respectively. Following the calculation formula introduced earlier, we can calculate the result. Please pay attention that in this formula, the unit vector CD and position vector RCB are different. They have different directions with different meanings. Please make sure you don't confuse them.